In this video, we'll look at how to install Anaconda Python 3 on Windows system. You can follow the same process for any version of Windows like Windows 10, Windows 11, Windows 8 or Windows 7 as well. Let's get started. So first we're gonna download our Anaconda Python. So for that, let's go ahead and open our browser. And here in the search bar, search for Anaconda download. So once you search for Anaconda download, in the first search result, you're gonna see the official website of Anaconda. So just click on it. So once you click on this one, so here, right inside, you can see this Anaconda individual edition, which is for Windows 64-bit and which comes along with the Python 3.9. So if you are interested in any other version like for macOS, Linux or Windows 32-bit, so just click on that and it will go to the bottom of this page. And here you can see for Windows 64-bit, 32-bit, same case with macOS and Linux. So here for Windows we have two options like for 64-bit and 32-bit. So my system has 64-bit, so I'm gonna go ahead and download for 64-bit. So now let's go ahead and click on this. So once you click on this one, it will pop up the new page. I think we don't need to do anything, just close that. And here you can see your download is started, which will take a while, and we wait till the download is completed. So Anaconda Python comes with a inbuilt Python package, so you don't need to install Python separately. In case if your system has already installed Python, so in that case it will install new version of Python, so you might see the two version of Python installed on your system. So it looks like our Anaconda Python is downloaded. So now let's close this and go to our download folder. So here you can see the exe for our Anaconda Python. So for installation, just double click on it. Let me minimize this. So this is our first page of our Anaconda Python installation. So here just go ahead and click on next. And here I agree. And here you have two options, just me and all user. So it means that it's gonna install only for my user, or if you click on all user, it's gonna install for all user. So when you go with all user, you have to make sure you have a admin privileges to install Anaconda on your system. So I'm going with all user and click on next. So this is the path where it's gonna install our Anaconda Python. So this is under C program data and Anaconda 3. In case if you go with that only user, so in that case you might see the different folder structure. And if you want to change this one, you just click on browse and you can redirect to any folder of your system, but I'm going with the default, so I just click on next. And here you have two options. First one is add Anaconda 3 to your system path. So if I click on that, it gives me some warning. So now let's go ahead and uncheck that. The second way is register Anaconda 3 as a system Python 3.9. I think we will go with the default and click on install, which will start the installation for our Anaconda Python 3, which will take a while, and we wait till the installation is completed. So our Anaconda Python 3 installation is completed. I think it took almost 50 minutes on my system, so it may take, you know, 10 to 15 minutes based on your system configuration. So now we go ahead and click on next, and here click on next. And here we have two options, for one is for tutorial and second for getting started with Anaconda. So now let's uncheck both and click on finish. Now let's go to our Windows menu, and here you can see the Anaconda installation. So now let's go ahead and click on Anaconda Navigator. So this is home page of our Anaconda Navigator. So here you can see the all the common software used for Python programming. So here we can see the Jupyter Notebook, Jupyter Lab, and then Spider and all this software. So for whichever the software you see the launch, this software comes pre-installed with the Anaconda, but wherever you see the install, you have to install separately. So here we can see that we have a Spider and Notebook installed with our Anaconda. So now let's go ahead and launch the Jupyter Notebook. So I click on launch. So here say allow, and this notebook will open in the our browser. So this is the home page for our Jupyter Notebook. So here you can see all this folder. So here we have something like download document, our desktop and other folders. So now let's go inside the desktop, and here let's create one folder. So for that click on new and click on folder, and for renaming just select that and click on rename, and here let's give the name called Python, and I click on rename. So my folder is rename. Now let's go inside this folder, and here we're gonna create our notebook. So I click on new and click on Python 3, which will open our new notebook. So this is our new notebook. So here first let's click on this button save, or maybe you can click on file and you say save as, and you give the name as maybe the simple, and click on save. So this is save as a simple one. Now let's type some program. So I say a, which is my string, and I assign that, and I give the value as my string, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna print the string, and for execution you have this run, so just click on it, so you will see the output of your string, which is my string. So this is how you can create and run the Python program on your Jupyter Notebook. So now let's minimize this, and now let's go back to our Anaconda Navigator, and here same way we'll look at the Spider. So click on launch, which will launch our Spider, and let's minimize this. So this is our Spider ID. So here you can write your Python program the way we wrote in the Jupyter Notebook. So first I'm gonna save this file. So I say file and I say save, and I'm gonna save on the same location. So I go to desktop, I go to Python, and I say sample.py, and I click on save. So my file is saved as simple.py. Same way here, let's define the string, and I say my string, and I'm gonna print that. So same way I say print and print my string, and if you want to execute, so here you have this icon, green icon, so just click on that, and here right inside you can see the output of your output, which is my string. So this is how you can create a Python program in the Spider ID. Now let's close this and close this as well. Now let's go to Anaconda Navigator. So here you can install other software like the Orange 3, PyCharm Professional, R Studio using Anaconda Navigator, which are not part of the pre-installed package of Anaconda. Now let's minimize and go back to our Windows menu, and here let's expand that, and let's open this Anaconda PowerShell. So this is our Anaconda PowerShell. Now let's go ahead and change the properties. So let's change this to 24 and let's maximize this. And here you just run command python hyphen hyphen and you say version. So you can see version python 3.9.7. same way, let's check the pip and I say version. So we have pip 21.2.4. so pip is utility which is used to install any module on your Python installation. So now for that, if you say pip and then say list, you're gonna get the all the module which are installed on your Python. So I have this number of module installed on my Anaconda Python. And if you want to install any new module on your Anaconda Python, so now I say pip and for installation say install and give your module name. So I'm gonna install pypdf3 and install it. So it's gonna download and install the pypdf3 module on my system. So now our pypdf3 package is installed. So again you say pip and then list, you're gonna see the package for pypdf3. So if you scroll up, so here you can see this pypdf3 which has a version 1.0.6 which is installed on our Anaconda Python. Yeah, that's all for this installation process. Hope this video will help you to install Anaconda Python 3 on your Windows system. And thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video.